In this video, we're going to take a look at adjustment layers in Final Cut Pro. I'll tell you what they are, what they're used for, and how you can add one in Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge, and welcome back to my channel for another Final Cut Pro tutorial. An adjustment layer is an object layer you place on top of your other layers in your project. Any effect applied to an adjustment layer affects all the clips below it, and there's a couple uses for it, which we'll look at a little bit later in this video. While adjustment layers are included in Photoshop, Premiere Pro, and many other photo and video editing apps, Final Cut Pro doesn't have them, so first you'll have to download and install it. Head over to lptguide.com/resources and download the adjustment layer zip file. Double-click this file to unzip it. Next, open Finder, select your home folder, and select Movies, Motion Templates, and open the Titles folder. Drag the LPT Guide custom folder you downloaded into your Titles folder. Close Finder, and restart Final Cut Pro. To apply an adjustment layer to your project, open the Titles and Generators browser, and select Titles. Scroll down and select the LPT Guide custom category and click the Final Cut Pro adjustment layer. Add this adjustment layer to your project just like you would any regular title. One of the most popular uses for adjustment layers is for adding color corrections and effects. I'll select my adjustment layer and, in the inspector, add a color correction. This color correction is applied to all the clips below my adjustment layer. Anything not under the adjustment layer is not affected. But look what happens when I ripple trim my adjustment layer over my next clip. The same color correction is applied to this clip because it's now under the adjustment layer. So if I stretch my adjustment layer over the entire length of my project, the same color correction is applied to all my clips. This also works for any effect in the effects browser. So if you want to apply a specific look or an effect to your entire project, instead of applying it to every clip, you just add it to your adjustment layer. Another use for adjustment layers is resizing or animating multi-layer compositions. For example, I have a simple logo here made up of 5 different layers. To resize or animate it, instead of doing each layer individually, I can just add an adjustment layer on top. Any of the transform parameters or keyframes added to the adjustment layer will transfer over to all the layers below it. There is one problem of doing it this way though. Say, for example, I want to have a video clip under my logo. If I add it under my logo, because it's under the adjustment layer, the video clip also has the transform parameters applied to it. If I want the video clip to remain unchanged, I would have to place it above the adjustment layer. But now you can't see anything under the top layer. To fix this, what I have to do is select the video clip layer, and in the inspector, from the blend mode drop-down menu, select Behind. This places my video clip behind all the other layers, but since it's above my adjustment layer, none of the effects or parameters applied to the adjustment layer affect my video. This is just a couple examples of what can be achieved with adjustment layers. Hopefully Apple will add adjustment layers to Final Cut Pro in one of the future updates, but until then, we have to add it manually. Head over to lptguide.com to download and install this adjustment layer absolutely free and try it out in your next project. As always, likes, comments, and shares are always appreciated. And if you haven't yet, make sure to hit that subscribe button. New videos released weekly. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.